acquire potential difference V. They acquire potential difference V. So I can say that finally, this will be C parallel into V equal to this. So what will be V? V will become equal to sigma CI VI divided by C parallel is nothing but sigma CI. So divide by sigma CI. That is the final result. Okay. V is equal to sigma CI VI upon sigma CI. If battery is connected, then voltage of battery only it will acquire. Also, one more thing here, we have to put the potentials with proper sign. If all positive are in same side, then all are positive. But if some positive, some are having positive left hand side and some are having positive right hand side, then because I am applying on this loop here, so I will take these positive and this one I will take as negative. Vn I will take as negative. So it will become minus Vn if this is minus and it is plus. The corresponding voltage, which is of opposite polarity, that will be taken with negative signs. Okay. Next we have if a dielectric is there, there are questions of heating effects also, like when the switch is closed or open, what happens as a result of that. Let me discuss a few questions like that. First of all, I'm trying to make a Wheatstone bridge. With capacitors in all these places, or maybe here it is switch. So this is a potential difference V here. Now, C1, C2, C3, C4. Question is, when the switch is closed, find charge flown through switch after closing it. What is the charge flow through the switch after it is closed? Right answer this question. What would it be?
Same as the supply by the battery.
After closing switch, the only difference that it will make is these two will become in parallel and these two will become in parallel and then they will be connected in series. Initially, what is the capacitance? Initial capacitance is
C1 C2 by C1 plus C2 plus C3.
C1 C2 upon C1 plus C2, that is here in the upper, and the lower side is
C3 C4 by
C3 C4 upon C3 plus C4. This is the equivalent. So, and what is the potential difference across this? V, and across the lower one also V. Then what would be the charge stored? The charge stored, let us call it maybe, what charge is here? Maybe Q1 I can say, and here it is, let us say Q2. Then I can simply say Q1 was equal to C1 C2 upon C1 plus C2 into V, and similarly Q2 was equal to C3 C4 upon C3 plus C4 into V. These were the charges initially, okay, when the potential difference across these was equal to V. It is before closing switch. What happens after closing now? After closing, these two became in parallel. So let us first connect them in parallel. Here it will become C1 plus C2, and then in series C2 plus C4, correct. So now what is the charge flown, total charge supplied by the battery this time? That charge is, let us say, Q here, and Q will be here also. What is Q value? Q value we can get by C1 plus C3 times C2 plus C4 upon C1 plus C3. Yes, C1 plus C2 plus C3 plus C4. This is multiplied by V. That is equal to Q charge supplied. This is after closing. But I have to also find out what is the charge on the C1 and C3 capacitor after closing. This is together I have taken. Can you find out individually what will be individual charges after closing?
Q by 2.
In what ratio charge will divide? Now, if I say C1 separately and C3 separately, and I know these are in parallel. If these are in parallel, then the potential difference across these will be same, whatever it is. Maybe you can take it, maybe V1. Potential difference is same. And I know that C1 V1 plus C3 V1, that total charge is Q, which is on both of these combined. That is equal to Q, which I have written here. Equation number 3. Let us call it equation number 1, equation number 2. And this diagram is after closing, and here we are getting question number 3. Now you tell me, in equation number 3, let us call it Q1 dash and Q2 dash are C1 V1 and this is C2 V2. What is V1 here? V1 is nothing but Q upon total C1 plus C3. So what is C1 V1? C1 into Q upon C1 plus C3 and C3 into V1. Sorry, it is V1 only. That is equal to C3 into Q upon C1 plus C3. I know the final charges. Then question was, what is the charge flown through the switch? Can you tell what is the charge flown through the switch?
So C1 charge, my total charge minus C1 and C3.
We will do like this here. To find out the charge flown through the switch, I think I will make this diagram. And I will take a loop here. This loop. This loop will have always conserved charge. If switch is closed, then it may not remain conserved because the charge may go through the switch. So what is the charge here initially? Initially charge here is Q1. Here it is minus Q1 and here it is plus Q1. Here it is again minus Q1 before closing. This is before closing. So before closing, the charge inside the closed loop is 0, right? What happens after closing? After closing, here charge is Q1 dash what is charge on the other side? Let us call it Q2 dash. And here it will be minus Q1 dash. So what will be the charge after closing?
Q1 dash minus Q2 dash.
Q2 dash minus Q1 dash, in fact. That is after closing charge inside. This is, let us call it Q final. So what is Q initial? Q initial is zero in this loop and Q final is this. So what is the charge which leaves? Q initial minus the charge which leaves. Charge flowing through switch. QS is charge leaving through switch. Then QI minus QS will become equal to, how much has gone here? QS has already gone. QI minus QS is equal to Q final. But what is QI? Zero. What is QS? QS, we don't know, minus QS is equal to Q final, Q2 dash minus Q1 dash. I know already what is Q1 dash. We have already derived what is Q1 dash here. Q1 dash is C1Q. C1 into Q upon C1 plus C3. Similarly, what is Q2 dash?
Q by C2 plus
C4. C2 into Q upon C2 plus
C4.
Why I'm taking Q only for that also? Because that charge is same. Total charge in C2 and C4 combination is same as total charge in C1 and C3 combination. So total charge is same. So that charge will be distributed in what ratio? It will go to, this is a, divided in C2 and C4. So it will go in proportion C2 upon C2 plus C4. In that proportion, it will go C2 upon C2 plus C4 into Q. That will go to charge to the C2 capacitor. This is capacitor C2. This is capacitor C1. C2 and C1. So we are getting answer finally. Answer is C2 C1 minus C2 C3. C2 C1 plus C2 C3 minus C2 C1 minus C2 C4 divided by the product C1 plus C3 multiplied by C2 plus C4 whole into Q. And Q also we know already. What was Q value?
C1 plus C3 into C2 plus C4 by C1 plus C2 plus C3 plus C4.
Q value we have derived somewhere. Yeah, it is product of C1, C3, this product upon sum, all sum. So this product is appearing in the denominator also. That product will cancel. So we will be getting at last answer as Q through the switch is equal to minus QS, right? Minus QS. So that is at last coming out to be C2, C1, cancel C2, C1. C2 into C3 minus C4 upon C1 plus C2 plus C3 plus C4 whole multiplied by V. That is minus QS. So what is QS? I have said QS is charge leaving through the switch. If I say charge entering the switch, then it will become
then plus.
Plus, it will become plus. So QS is equal to minus of this. That is only leaving, if I assume it to be leaving the switch. Okay. Right. That is answer. What is work done by battery?
Q into
second
V.
Second question. Work done by battery is not Q into V. Work done by battery will be the new charge which is supplied by the battery. We have to find that. Already there was charge already initially. What was the initial charge? Initial charge was already Q1 plus Q2. And what is the final charge? Final charge is this. So what is the extra charge supplied? Final charge minus initial charge. Okay. Work done by battery will be Q final charge supplied by the battery. Final total charge on the system and initial total charge on the system was Q1 plus Q2. So whole into V, that is work done by battery in this process. This is worked on by the battery in this process. What is heat energy produced in this process?
Q
heat energy produced in this process will be equal to can you tell what it will be
half c net into v square
heat energy produced will not be like that so it will be work done by battery minus
change in potential energy.
We know work done by battery here and we know what is the change in potential energy then we can take the difference and we can get the answer okay work done by battery minus change in potential energy that will be equal to heat energy produced okay what is the initial energy by the way initial energy can be written as half into total q1 plus q2 into v that is initial what is final half into 2 into v then the change means final minus initial minus of that and here work done by battery so what it will come out to be finally I think it will come out to be half of q minus
q1 plus q2 into v
means it is nothing but it is coming out to be work done by battery divided by 2 you can check it by solving it comes out to be this just put this value here and take the difference we will be getting this only okay and for series yesterday do you remember what I concluded for series I have concluded that if I have C series for charge capacitors C series and effectively I have taken V let me name this V is the let me name external battery is V but with this because of the charging let me assume some battery Vs is connected in series this is because of charge capacitors so whatever is the potential difference across the charge capacitors that I can assume that will contribute to like a battery in connected in series and this is now uncharged so main diagram was this CS V and across it what was the potential Vs and there was a switch here and we closed the switch this was the situation actually okay potential across CS was Vs but now I can connect it separately I will assume it to be like uncharged capacitor connected in series with the battery having potential difference Vs and that V battery which is connected externally that will also be there now I told you yesterday that in this case what would be work done by battery will be simply the charge which is supplied
q into V minus
into V that is only work done by battery just the extra charge which is supplied q into V what will be this extra charge supplied that will be q final minus q initial no we can't say something can we say that what it will be q initial is not defined because it is different in different places I think I have to say just this only q into v q is the new charge which is supplied in this that is worked in the battery and I have discussed what is the heat energy produced Do you know that I cannot write the potential energy formula for this as what is the potential energy of this capacitor? Can you write it as half of Cs into Vs square? No,
no
not. Why not? Because it is not that simple situation. It is C1, V1, and it is C2, V2. So these are separate potentials across these, and these are all connected in series, and the charges are also not same. Charges are unequal. Charges are not equal here. Here it is Q1, maybe here it is Q2, and these are different charges. All are separately. Then when I will try to write the net potential energy formula, what I can write? I will have to write maybe half of C1 V1 square plus C2 V2 square and so on. Or I could write half of Q1 square by C1 plus Q2 square by C2 plus and so on. So I have no right to take directly half of Q net square upon C because CS, because there is no such Q existing. These are all separate Q values. So I can't write it as a single half of Q square by CS. That I can't do in this case. Okay. These all have to be treated separately. So if somebody has to write potential energy in such cases, when they are having initial charge, remember, when they are having initial charge, then we have to write separately and we have to add. Separately and we have to add. We can't write total half of Q square by CS. And we can't write half of CS into VS square. That will become wrong. Okay. What is VS, by the way, here? VS is nothing but VS is the total V1 plus V2 plus
V minus
so on up to VN. The total series voltage which is appearing across the capacitors. Okay. So anyway, what we get, so what is the usefulness of the this total circuit which we are writing, which we are drawing here? What is the advantage of this? One advantage is that we can get work done by battery. Its main advantage is only to find out Q. What will be charge supplied? Charge supplied is easy to obtain. That is just V minus Vs into Cs directly. The potential difference into capacitors in series. That is a new charge supplied. After new charge supplied is obtained, one more thing we can use it to for, that is heat energy dissipated. What was heat energy dissipated you obtained yesterday?
Yes, V net square.
It was coming out to be
half CS into V net square.
Half CS into V net square. Half CS into V minus VS square, right? That was it coming out to be. So its main advantage is to find out Q. And other thing to find out the heat energy dissipated, but don't use it to find out the potential energy change. Indirectly, we can get potential energy change. How? Work done by battery is easy, already obtained, is equal to delta U plus H. So I can tell delta U will be work done by battery minus H, which will come out to be this Q into V minus half of CS into V minus
CV square.
This is change in potential energy. So indirectly obtain it in this way. Okay. But we can open it up, then we will be getting Q into V minus half of CS into
QV. We can write CV square.
I can replace Q as what will be Q?
CS
into V net.
It will become CS into V square minus CS into V into VS, right?
Yes, sir.
Let us write it then that way only. Then what potential change in potential energy will come out to be? CS into V square minus CS into V into VS and minus. Now, next, solving it, what we get? Minus half of CS into V square, minus half of CS into VS square, and plus CS into V into VS. This product term gets cancelled.
Half CS square minus VS square.
We are getting finally
half CS of V square minus VS square.
CS of VS square. And half CS of V square minus VS square. That is a change in potential energy. Okay. So we are getting it then. Right? Directly also, you know, we can use it directly. If we remember this formula, then we can directly obtain delta U as well. So delta U and work done by battery is this Q into V. Total Q is this. And heat supplied is half CS into V minus VS square. That is heat energy dissipated. All right. I want to verify this formula once again by another method as well. What is the normal standard way to find out the change in potential energy? Normal way will be
individual charges.
Half of final charge. Final charge will be Q plus. Initial charge was CI VI.
Sigma CI.
This is square by CI square. That is final potential energy. What is initial potential energy? Initial charge was just initial potentials are VI. VI square half of CI into VI square, right? So what will be U final minus U initial? Sigma of this. Let us take it and put it together. What do we get? We get delta U is equal to sigma half into Q square plus CI square VI square divided by CI plus 2 into CI into Q into VI.
Half of.
Minus half of CI VI square. This total we have to take. What we are getting then? Half is just constant taken out. CI VI square term is appearing in both. That is getting cancelled. Then we are left with Q square plus what is it inside? 2CI.
VIQ.
VI into Q. That only?
Yes. We need to substitute
the denominator Q. C1 is 0.
Yes, sir.
Denominator
by Q
square by C1 will be there, sir.
Okay, CI square by CI. It is not C1, it is CI.
Yes, sir. Q square by CI plus 2VIQ, sir.
And next is
2VIQ, yes.
Correct. This is right. Now, would it be that or not? That we have to check again.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That only?
1 minute, sir.
It seems to be different to me. That is equal to half of. I have to put QI value. What was QI value? Q was equal to V minus VS into CS. Plus 2 into VI. Then we are getting half of Q into sigma. What is 1 by CI is Q by, I can write this as Q by CS plus 2 into sigma VI. Sigma VI is nothing but V series, total V in series. And this is Q upon CS, sigma. So what we are getting then at last? CS is just, now it, it will not be, sigma will not remain when I have already written CS. Sigma will no more remain there. Then we are getting half of Q square by CS.
Plus 2V, sorry, 2QVS will be there, sir.
Plus 2 will cancel Q into?
Sir, no, sir. There
will cancel.
Cancel, right? Then we are getting different or same?
No.
What was last time?
We are getting now V square plus VS square.
What is Q? Q is equal to?
CS of V minus VS.
Half of CS into V minus VS square plus Cs into V minus Vs into Vs. Then we are getting V square plus Vs square minus 2 Vs into V into Cs into half plus Cs into.
Yes, sir, we are getting same.
Same, sir, same.
Getting same. Thank God we are getting same only, otherwise it will be completely disaster. So, right, what we are getting at last, finally cancel the terms and tell me what we are getting. Cs into?
Half of Cs into V square minus Vs square.
Minus Vs square, right?
Yes, sir.
Right. So, this we are getting as change in potential energy. So, we are able to get the change in potential energy when they are all connected in series, and it is a simple result at last. At last, it is just half of Cs into V square minus Vs square. Right. This is it. We can test it now. And actually, why I needed to derive it in this method, by this method, because I have told you yesterday this formula, but I did not derive it yesterday. You remember? Heat formula. I did not derive it.
So you derived for one capacitor.
And I just proved it for one capacitor, but what is true for one may not be true for n number. So yesterday I felt need to derive, but I thought, okay, because I had already derived it last year and I was sure about that, so I just verified it. But today I derived it. How you may consider it like a derivation? See,
delta U,
because delta U we derived completely. Delta U we derived from the basic only. After deriving delta U, we can go back and we can use this formula. We can use this work done is equal to delta U plus H. And while we use that, then we will be getting H from there only. So H will come out to be same. Okay. Have you understood how it is complete derivation, proper derivation now?
Because I have
yes,
sir. When we are taking WB initially in before yesterday, we have taken WB is equals to Q into V net, sir.
No, not Q into V net. Will never be W.
Q into V only have taken.
Q into V only will be WB. That will never be Q into V net. That will be always Q into V. Because battery is only having potential V. Vs is just not battery. It is, we can say, apparently connected in series. Just to for the. We are assuming it to be connected in series so that we can derive Q very fast. That is the only reason. I am not saying that you cannot derive Q otherwise. You can derive Q otherwise also by slowly writing the KVL equation. That we also we can do. But chances are some student commits mistake in writing that. So I just gave you a well cooked formula directly. You can directly use it all directly. Q is equal to V minus Vs into Cs. Directly we can use it. So don't say that work done by battery will be that thing. Q into V net. No, it will never be Q into V net. How can battery is only V? So that will do only work, which is the work done by battery will always be charge supplied by the battery into V. Okay. If you say what is in this work done by this total structure, this plus this, then I could say probably Q into V minus Vs. But battery is this only. This is not battery. It is just connected in series with Cs because I told you a single charge capacitor can be assumed to be uncharged capacitor connected in series with a battery. Okay, so it is coming from that anyway. All right, next we have one capacitor, another capacitor, both connected in. Forgetting the exact question here. Let me suffer from Irodov.